it in 1 minute. Company!
Platoon!
Attention!
As they move forward into battle. The colors have traditionally been at the side of the commander and were carried forward even when the commander fell in combat. All others may perish, but the colors live on. The guidon is an extension of the unit colors to the company level. With the transfer of the guidon here today goes the transfer of responsibility for the accomplishment of Bravo 2nd 156 Infantry's mission and the welfare of the troops. The senior NCO of the organization is traditionally responsible for maintenance and care of the colors. And so, the first sergeant passes the unit guide on to the outgoing commander, Captain Gibbs, signifying the unit's appreciation for his leadership and guidance. Captain Gibbs passes the company guide on to the battalion commander, signifying the relinquishing of his command and gratitude for the opportunity to lead the soldiers. Major Toops then passes the guide on to the incoming commander, Captain Cambry, entrusting him with responsibility and care of the unit. Captain Cambry passes the guide on back to the first sergeant, signifying his trust and confidence in the leaders and soldiers of the organization. In accordance with AR 600-20, paragraph 3-4, the undersigned assumes command of Bravo 2nd 156 Infantry, New Iberia, Louisiana, effective 06 January 2021. Signed, Captain Brandon R. Cambry, commanding. Ladies and gentlemen, the commander of 2nd 156th Infantry, Major Lawrence Toops.
Good morning.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Good morning, sir.
Very good. All right. Well, wasn't really expecting to be doing a change of command today. I don't think anybody else here was either until about yesterday afternoon. But due to some unexpected life circumstances, here we are. All right. It's both a great thing when you get to do a change of command, because you give someone new the opportunity to lead a unit, and it's also a sad event because it's the end of someone else's command time. Come out of command a couple times, and I would say it's exciting to go into it, and it's a real drag when you come out of it because there's no experience like leading, especially a company, where you still are at mostly the direct leadership level. Honored with that position. It's a lot of responsibility, but it's extremely rewarding. And I know these two guys can both attest to that. He's coming out of one, he's already had one, he's gonna take another one. So, briefly, I've watched Captain Gibbs grow as a commander since right before XCTC back in 2018. Led Bravo Company well through that, especially the long night march from hell to attack the Cactus, right? And then similar experiences in JRTC with a very good live fire exercise, and then some very painful multiple attacks on the tour, and then the defense at the end. If you were there, you understand what I'm talking about. But JRTC is meant to suck, and suck it did. But did an outstanding job leading your company through it. Bravo Company might be a little partial. A lot of the best commanders go through there, myself included. You know, JRTC, you guys did a great job under your skilled leadership, and then as well as everything from that point forward, dealing with COVID, right? A lot of you guys were on temporary COVID orders, all that stuff all year long. What else? 5 hurricane activations in the midst of all that, and trying to get ready for Primo, or get ready for the mobilization and do all our training when we can't actually get together to train. So this year, since JRTC, has been extremely challenging, though not in a tactical sense, just in an organizational sense. It's been pretty difficult, but you guys have done an outstanding job. You have done an outstanding job leading the unit through all that, and I'm very sorry to see you go. But I understand we are where we are, and if you guys have been in the Army for a hot minute, or the military at all, you know that change is constant, right? And if you don't like change, you're in the wrong job, because everything we do here is about change and staying on top of it in a proactive manner so that we maintain the initiative against the enemy, who is also going through his own change and anticipating what we do. And if you maintain the initiative against him, you get inside his decision cycle. That's how you win. All right? So change can be a negative or a positive thing, but as long as you have a positive outlook upon it, you're going to be fine. Cool? What has not changed is the discipline of Bravo Company and the fighting spirit of the soldiers that make it up. Who was it? Shit, I'm blanking now. Who was the general that said this? All right, so I'm gonna skip who it was because I didn't write it down and I'm blanking now, but a commander is only good as the soldiers that he leads, right? So Captain Gibbs has done an outstanding job leading Bravo Company. That is only because of the outstanding soldiers that make up Bravo Company. So as long as you do your part, you maintain your high level of fitness, discipline, tactical ability, positive outlook, and no quit attitude, you will succeed just as fine under Captain Cambry or whoever leads you in the future. It doesn't matter. Let's let him pass.
Thank you.
soapbox. Just want to say again, thank you for all your hard work. I spent there as well, not just being the battalion command, right? Just because I spent a lot of time in New Iberia. I love the place. I love the people there. Now we've got an almost entirely new Bravo company, right? We've got people from all over the fucking South making it up. But it's still the same as it was before. Hard charging, no quit, and gonna go over there and do the fucking job that we're getting paid to do, right?
Cool.
That's what I thought. All right, Captain Cambry, I know you're gonna do a great job leading these dudes. Back to being a pain in the ass commander, right? But that's all right, because, you know, you don't always get a second chance to do it. So appreciate it. Lead them well. Take them from where they are with Captain Gibbs, and then just get them to the next level. Okay? Because that's what we do. When you get replaced as a leader, you always want the unit to get better after you go. Because then you know you did a good job leading your troops, training them, and getting them ready to go to the next level. We don't go backwards in the Army. We only go forwards. Cool?
Cool.
That's all I got, thank you.
The former commander of Bravo, 2nd 156 Infantry, Captain Joshua Gibbs.
As a commander, I never woke up in the morning and said, I'm gonna be the best commander. I only woke up in the morning and hoped by the end of the day I could look myself in the mirror and say that I did my best. Not just for me, but that I gave you my best. And I hope that that's what I've done, and that's what I've instilled in all of you. I know most of you in this formation aren't going to be under Captain Cambry, and you served under me. I thank each and every one of you in this formation for letting me lead you. Leadership is a two-way street. I can't do it unless you let me, and you let me, and I thank you for that, and I'm humbled for that. Each and every day. This is a bittersweet goodbye. You guys are going off to fight battles in a foreign land, and I gotta go fight a battle at home. Again, I ask that you please just give the same dedication and commitment to each other and commitment to mission that you gave me. Turn that around and give that to Captain Cameron. Alright? He's a great guy. I've known him for several years of my career now. We worked together in the J3 shop to an extent. He's not going to do you wrong. Alright? Where's Daigle at?
Here, sir.
Daigle, I thank you for always stepping in and being that NCO that this company needed, even when there wasn't a particular one at the time. You never failed me. And you never failed the men in this formation. And I particularly thank you for that. That's all I got.
The commander of Bravo, 2nd 156 Infantry, Captain Brandon Cambry.
Morning, Bravo Company.
Morning, sir.
I'd like to thank Major Tubes, Sergeant Major, give me the opportunity to take company command again. Look forward to leading you. We'll always try to be fair. Always trying to take care of you to the best of my ability. I don't care what color you are, father earmuffs for a second. I don't care who you choose to sleep with. I don't care who you choose to worship, if you choose to worship at all. I'll treat you the same. I will view you as you're either in the wagon because you're young and you're learning, you're a leader, you're out front carrying the wagon, pulling the wagon, or you're behind, dragging the wagon behind. If you were behind, we're gonna have a long couple months together. Do not be in that category, and we will do great things together. Captain Gibbs, appreciate all the hard work you've done with this company. Sorry to take over in such circumstances, but you definitely have a fight you've got to go home and take care of. I will do my best to take care of every single soldier here, and look forward to seeing you when we return home. Best of luck to you. If we can do anything at all, please let us know. That is all. Thank you.
Take charge of your company. Stand fast. So we didn't have time to do an award for Captain Gibbs. So best I can do is give you a coin in appreciation for all your service to the unit. Good luck, and I will be following up with an award after this.
All right.
Carry on.
This concludes Bravo 2156 Infantry Change of Command Ceremony.
Something that I left behind. The hearts I have touched would be the proof that I leave, that I made a difference, and this world will see. I won't